साइंस कम्युनिकेशन के बारे में हमें कुछ बताइए कि एग्जैक्टली साइंस कम्युनिकेशन क्या है, अगर हम किसी लेमैन को समझाना चाहें तो.
ओके, कैन आई टेल अ स्टोरी?
यस सर, श्योर.
दिस इज अ फोक टेल. सो इन दिस फोक टेल, ए फिश एंड अ फ्रॉग आर फ्रेंड्स. ओके, नॉट फ्रॉग, टैडपोल.
टैडपोल.
Tadpole only grows and becomes a frog.
Hmm.
So when it is a tadpole, where does it live? In water.
In water.
Where does a fish live?
Water.
Water. So both of them are friends. They are swimming in the pond. They are all happy. One day, tadpole becomes
frog.
So when it becomes frog, what has happened? It jumps into the land.
Jumps into the land.
So when it is on the land, and because its close friend is a fish, it has to describe the land to the fish, right? So how will it describe? Suppose if the frog goes and tell the fish, I saw clouds, they are very nice. There are tall, tall trees, they are very beautiful. Will it make any sense to the fish?
No.
Because fish has never seen a cloud, would never see a tree, right? So then maybe the frog has to say something like a jellyfish floating on a pond. There are something like a white stuff which floats. That's called cloud.
Relatable.
Yeah. So, when I say this, I am also making a claim that people, within quotes, are ordinary people or lay public, whichever way you want to call it, or in a pond. And the science communicator is a frog. And science is the land. Science is the land. Our everyday experience is a pond. And science communicator is somebody who is able to go here and there. That's what I am claiming.
Yes.
But I need to prove this. Let's prove it. I kick a ball. What will happen to the ball?
Will start rolling off.
How then?
After some time, it will stop.
Stop. We will never ask a question why it stops in our everyday life.
Yes, sir.
Okay. In everyday life, you don't give an explanation of why it stops. But if suppose in some place, the ball goes for a longer distance, in our everyday life, we will say that, oh, there is no friction. That's everyday life. But whereas, if I'm going to the land of physics, according to Newton's first law, the ball kicked should be keep on going forever. So, we are giving explanation of why the ball stopped, not why the ball moved. Okay, but in our everyday life, we will be giving explanation of why the ball moves, not why the ball stops. Because for us, ball stopping is natural. Why the ball is moving is the puzzling part. But whereas in the land of physics, moving is not a puzzling part. Why it is stopping is a puzzling part.
मतलब कि basically physics में जो चीज हम लोग समझा रहे हैं कि
counterintuitive. I drop two objects from the same height. One is 500 kilo, the other is 5 gram. Which will hit the ground first?
If we neglect the air friction, मतलब अगर हम लोग
Everybody most likely would immediately say that the
जो भारी है वो ज़्यादा जल्दी गिरेगा. हाँ.
But what does the science say?
दोनों same time पे गिरेंगे.
Assuming that there is no air friction or the role of air friction is very less, right? Yeah. So the world of science is counterintuitive. It's counterintuitive in many ways. For example, this is again one example that I tell people. One day, my wife is inside. She should not hear. If she hears, then I'll get a beat up. Okay.
Okay.
So silently we'll talk.
Okay.
One day I called my wife. And then she told me that it's raining in Delhi. That time I was outside Delhi. I was wondering, is it raining? This is not the rainy period. She said, no, 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 it's raining. I can hear the sound. Then I asked her, oh, what, how? I'm still on the bed, but I can hear the sound of the rain. Then I thought, maybe unusual rain. Evening, I come to know, that it was not raining. It was an overflowing tank. What is the purpose that I am saying? In science, we don't believe if a person says. In everyday life, if you say something, it is it's a kind of a moral duty for me to believe you. Right? But in science, we don't believe. We need evidence.
We need evidence.
It's counterintuitive. It's very, very difficult for people. Okay? This you can see in our behavior itself, right? I mean, see when there is a small child and you say that child, please drink the milk. The child asks, why? We get immediately offended, right? I am such an older person, I am such a senior person, you are such a small person. So, I'll tell you, you do it.
Yes, sir.
But the beauty of science or the importance of science, the fundamental crux of science is asking that question, why should I drink the milk? Correct?
Yes,
sir. So, our everyday life, the logic, our prejudices, our priori knowledge of everyday life, many times are counterintuitive to what actually the world is, what actually the universe is. Okay? So, there is our everyday experience, everyday life. There is the world of science, where there is a lot of unknowability or unfamiliarity to our audience. So, the role of science communicator is to be a frog. Travel to the world of land, explain it in terms of the pond. That's a simple.
That's a very beautiful explanation of science communication.